In this video, we're going to define what guided access is, how to set it up, we're going to see it in action, and we're going to go through a number of usage scenarios. We're going to use three different types of visual indicators. We'll use a hand every time I tap. Every time I hit a button on the outside of the device, we'll give you an icon, and we'll use arrows to help point out key information on screen. Apple defines guided access as the ability to limit an iOS device to one app by disabling the home screen, as well as restricting touch input on certain areas of the screen. In other words, not only can you control the buttons on screen, like the home button, you can also control sensors like the touch sensor and the motion sensor. Let's start with setting up guided access. Tap on the Settings app, tap on the General tab. On the General tab, scroll up or down to find Accessibility. Tap on Accessibility. Using your finger, scroll up or down to find Guided Access. Under General Accessibility Guided Access, you will be able to turn Guided Access on. So to turn it on, I touch the on-off slider, and two settings appear. First is set passcode. Now, when I was first experimenting with this, it wasn't apparent that you had to set a passcode. So what I'm telling you is you have to set a passcode, otherwise you're going to go through the same problem that I went through. So setting a passcode is really easy. Tap on set passcode. It's going to give you a 4-digit number to put in. I'm going to, for the sake of this demo, pick a very easy one. I would recommend for you to pick something more complex. But for this demo, there we go. I've now set my passcode and confirmed it. The other thing is, the iPad assumes that when you are in guided access mode, that you are facilitating this with someone else for someone else's usage, and you want the application to be on all the time. If you're in a teaching environment, as an example, and you want the iPad to turn off even when you're staying in that application, then you would enable screen sleep. But by default, it's not enabled. So let's see guided access in action. The first thing I'm going to do is find an app to show you how this works. So this is a one-button app, and when I touch the button, it makes a noise. I'll show you. I'll tap on the button right now.
Radical.
And you can see it made that noise. It says the word radical. So probably the most exciting feature in guided access is the ability to shut off the home button. I'll show you an example of when the home button's not shut off. In this case, I haven't turned on guided access yet, and so when I tap the home button, which I'm going to do right now, it takes me back to the home screen. Let's get back in the application. So if I want to disable that feature, I need to turn on guided access. Now, there are other ways of disabling this feature, like putting a physical barrier over the home button, piece of foam core, or a bub cap, or a plastic plate. Or I've also seen cases that have a slider switch that covers the home button. So this is a way of doing it via software versus hardware. So let me show you how to do that. First thing I need to do is to turn guided access on for the application. And in order to do that, I triple tap on the home button. So 1, 2, 3, and it launches the guided access menu. In the lower left-hand corner is the hardware button. And as you can see, it is always off. One of the primary features of guided access is when it's activated, it automatically turns off the home button. So let me show you how that works. So I need to start guided access, and in the upper right-hand corner, I tap on the start button. And you can see by the pop-up, guided access is now turned on. If I tap on the home button, let me show you what happens. So I'm going to tap on the home button, and I get a menu that says guided access is enabled, triple tap to exit. So if I tap, I'm going to now double tap. Again, I get the same menu. I have to triple tap. So now I've just triple tapped, and now this is where the passcode comes into play. This is why you have to set a passcode. Otherwise, you couldn't get into the menu, get past this point. So let me type in our password. So that's how the guided access prevents you, turns off the home button. Guided Access also does two other really great things. The first thing that it does is it turns off certain sensors. So if you have applications that you want to turn off the entire screen, let's say it's a music app that reacts to the motion sensor, and you want to turn off the screen to prevent users from doing other things with it, then you can tap on the touch, and you can see now the screen is grayed out. So when if I hit resume, let's do that. I'll hit resume. And if I tap anywhere, which I'm doing on the screen right now, I'm tapping all over the screen and the button isn't being activated. So that's how to turn the whole screen off. Tap three times. 1, 2, 3. And now add my passcode. Now I'm back in the system. I'm going to turn touch back on. And that's simply by touching the on-off button. By tapping the on-off button, it'll turn back on. And I can also turn off the motion sensor. So this would be an example. Let's say you have an application that, like an Etch-a-Sketch, it's a drawing application that erases itself or plays something or does something with the motion sensor. You can turn that off as well. I'm not going to demonstrate it here, but you get the idea. So the third and final feature of Guided Access that everyone is excited about is the ability to turn off portions of the screen. So how would you turn off portions of the screen? And the way you do that is by drawing. So in this Guided Access area, you draw where you want the screen to be turned off. So I'll show you a couple of different shapes you can draw. So I can draw a square, I can draw a circle, and I can draw a long rectangle. You can also, as you can see here, draw unusual shapes as well. So I'm going to exit that. So let's say I was trying to draw around this area there. So you can see that it will do, sometimes it does unusual shapes, sometimes it doesn't. But let's say, for the sake of this demonstration, I just want to turn off the radical button. Let's say there were other buttons as an example. So I'm going to just draw myself a circle, then bring it using my finger and tap and slide it over. And then I'm going to tap and hold on one of the handles and just draw this out to be a little bit bigger. I'm going to exit out of that small one. So you can see here I've only turned off a portion of the screen. Now, where this is really exciting is those little setup buttons in the corner, or those buttons that launch out other applications because they always want you to buy more stuff. You can turn all those off. What's very, very cool about Guided Access is this is saved on a per application basis. So you can go through and set these all up in advance, and then it's turned off per application. So these hotspots are per application. So let me show you this. So I'm going to hit resume to activate the app, and you can now see that in that circled area, the app is deactive, and I'm going to touch it. I've just touched it. You can't see me touching it, but I just touched it a couple times and it does not trigger the radical button. So that is the key features of Guided Access. There's one last feature I want to show you, and that is what happens if you try and put the wrong passcode in. So 1, 2, 3, and I'm going to put in the wrong passcode and look at what happens. For 10 seconds I'm locked out. Now this is interesting, because what if you have a user that just sits there every 10 seconds and keeps trying to type in passwords to defeat your code? I'm going to do it again, and now I'm locked out for 60 seconds. So that's very interesting. I thought that was interesting. So it was a way of keeping people from fixating on the button and sort of managing that process. I can also think for some users that they'd be very, very frustrated, and that might be a cause of great dissatisfaction. So you may have to manage that a little bit with your user. One of the first usage scenarios that came to mind when we started looking at Guided Access is when you're going to use the iPad primarily as a single-use device. So for example, the thing that immediately comes to mind is when you're using an iPad primarily as an augmentative alternative communication, or AAC, device. In those scenarios, or often in those scenarios, the user 95% of the time is going to be in one application trying to use it. They may have multiple iPads doing a couple different things, but they're going to be using it in one primary function, and so it's perfect. So let me show you how to set this up for an AAC user. Set up Guided Access for an AAC user where you wouldn't want them to get out of the app. So on screen I have speech button. I'm going to tap on speech button, and I have a communication board set up already. So what I want to do is just turn on Guided Access. So triple tap, 1, 2, 3, and all I have to do is start. So now I'm locked in. If I tap the home button, it'll give me an error message, and I now every time I want to come back to this device, it's always set up for on this page for AAC or within this app. So if you had multiple pages, then you could scroll within the app. So this is perfect for that application. Now the other comment that I will make is, if you go to our setup video, there's also a setting to be able to dim the screen. So if you're going to do AAC and it's always going to be locked as an AAC device or single-use device, then I would also put the screen setter on, saver on, so that it will protect the battery life. I want to show you a guided access usage scenario we're calling in-app control. There are times that where you're going to want to prevent a user from touching certain buttons inside of an application. So I want to show you how to set that up using guided access. On screen, I'm going to tap on the flashcard app, and it launches the flashcard app. In the upper left-hand corner, you can see the Facebook and Twitter buttons. So if I tap on those buttons, it's going to launch the web browser and knock me out of this application and put me in a totally different other application. So if I want to prevent a user from doing that, I'm going to use guided access to do that. So let me show you how to set that up. Tap on the home screen three times, one, two, three, and now you're in the guided access control panel. And so I just want to draw a box around Facebook and Twitter. And so you can see me do that. And there's my box. So I just now press the start button, and guided access is now started, and you can see in the upper left-hand corner that it's grayed out where I drew my little box. And if I touch on those boxes, it does not launch out Facebook and Twitter. So that's exactly what I want. Now, let me show you some problems that we found. In the upper right-hand corner, you can see the setup button. So if I tap on the setup button, you can see that. You can see the mute button, and you can see a lock button. Now, I'm going to use guided access to draw a circle around those to prevent my users from accessing those, and I want to show you what happens. One, two, three, to launch guided access. I need to enter my passcode because I'm in guided access mode. Type in my passcode, and I'm going to draw a box around that rectangle. So there it is. There's my rectangle. I mean, my box around those three items, and I'm going to press resume now to launch guided access again. Now, with the Facebook, and I'm tapping on Facebook, that didn't work. But if I tap on to the setup button, even though it's grayed out, watch what happens. So I'm tapping now. There, it launches setup, and I can hit the done button, and not only was the setup button and the done button underneath the restricted area for guided access, but they both worked. So what does that mean? It means that buttons have different access levels within an application, but it also means from an end user perspective, you need to test all of your guided access well before you're going to use it with an end user to make sure it works the way that you want it to work. Some buttons are going to work in some areas of the screen are going to work perfectly. Other areas, like setup buttons, may or may not work depending on if the developer has written for guided access or not, and depending on how that program is written for that button. So test. That's the answer. I think the usage scenario that gets people the most excited about guided access is the idea that they don't have to use a plastic plate or keep their hand over the home button to prevent users from switching from app to app. So let me show you how you would do that. If I'm in a group setting and I want to launch this, I'm going to launch this and use this application, I would then need to put it into guided access mode, triple tap to get it into guided access mode, and then hit start. Then I can hand that off to a user, and if the user tries to get out of the app by hitting on the home button, then they get the familiar error message. The problem that we see is in an environment where you're switching from app to app to app, using guided access just needs to be managed because you have to a couple of extra steps. I've got to triple tap. I've got to enter my passcode. I then need to end guided access. I need then hit the home button, then launch the second app, then triple tap again, and hit start to launch it for the second app. So as long as it's managed, you can work around the extra time it's going to take. For more information, go to iPadsForSpecialNeedsBook.com, where you'll find more videos, other resources like cheat sheets, and a book on how to use the iPad for your special needs user.